Hallelujah, and good morning to you. Welcome to the Christmas season, and welcome to the little studio for some devotional time here this morning. Miss Ann and I are glad that you stopped by, and my name's David Johnson, if you've not been here before, and that's Miss Ann running the camera over there. And our aim is to share the good news about our Savior Jesus Christ with whoever wants to listen. And the good news is that Jesus is the Son of God, and He wants you to live with Him forever. And He was willing to die for your sins just so you could do that very thing. So stick around for a few minutes, if you will, and we'll talk about that thing. And also, if you'd like to stay tuned at the 11 o'clock hour, just come on over and be with us online. If you're watching us on Facebook now, it's the same Facebook page of Arbor Grove United Methodist Church for our morning worship service. Today kicks off our Advent season, and the songs and the messages from Pastor Susan Pillsbury Taylor will be telling the Christmas story all over again. So come be online with us if you can. We'd sure love for you to be there. Now, I don't know about you, but don't the world seem to be going by awfully fast these days? It seems like we just packed up all that Christmas stuff from 2021, and here it is, dadgummit, Christmas 2022. This train's in high gear, I'm going to tell you, and it's picking up speed, if you believe me. My dear old Aunt Mary lived me in her 90s. And she said that it would happen to me, and it did. For her, the years became just like 2 or 3 months going by. And the older she got, she said the weeks got to be just 2 or 3 days long. And now Miss Annie and I feel that same passing of time in our lives. But I'll bet you that it seemed like that to every generation in history as they got older. Because after all, life's a journey. That's all it is. And eventually our journey starts going downhill, and I believe it picks up steam every year. Now, I really do. And every generation has experienced its own particular journey with its ups and downs. The 40s and the 50s and the 60s and on back before that. And that age-old fight between good and evil has played out with each batch of folks that came along ever since time began. And God has been present for every day and every minute of it, because He made this whole ball of wax, and it's His plan for mankind that's unfolding. Now, we've talked about the journey of the children of Israel before, and you've heard it preached and taught, their travels from the days of their slavery in Egypt to finally reaching the promised land to settle there and to flourish. This was thousands of years back. But we know that Satan intervened in their lives just like he wants to mess around in ours. He caused them to rebel against God and His law. So their journey took them downhill from being a once great nation under King David and Solomon and folks like that to a civil war that tore their country apart. And even when they got past that somewhat, outside forces came in and eventually conquered both halves of the country and took many of the people away into captivity and occupied their homeland. It was bad times. But God didn't forget His people. And after 70 years of captivity, if you read your scripture, you'll find where He allowed them to return and rebuild some of what they lost a century before. And so for many generations, the remnant of Israel was now called Judah and later Judea, and it was home again to the descendants of the children of Israel. And they were looking to rise again, to be an independent nation. They wanted to be in charge of their destiny with a strong military and a strong leader. But that Roman Empire had risen up and was now the big power in the world at that time. And the Romans came in and they occupied the Holy Land with God's chosen people there. And the journey became a hard one again, with taxation and forced obedience to Roman edicts and direction. And in many ways, the journey turned just bitter. But God's plan for mankind was still on track, and His plan for His people was still on track. It never wavered. And God was about to send the leader that Israel wanted, but he would not be the type of leader that they were looking for. You see, mankind was sinful, and we always had been. Clear back to the Garden of Eden, Satan could talk us into anything, and he talked us into disobeying God. And when the Lord kicked Adam and Eve out of the Garden of Eden, all the way back there in Genesis, they began a journey that's still going on today. Human beings trying to find their way back home. We're like little youngins out in a rainstorm trying to find our way back into the house. Back to the Father that's waiting for us, watching for us, giving us every advantage to come back to Him. And during the Roman occupation of about 2,000 years ago in that Judean area, the journey of many people and what would eventually become the journey of all people, and this means me and you, was beginning, but it was beginning for a young couple. They were planning on getting married. It was beginning for a group of shepherds that knew no life other than taking care of their sheep. That journey was beginning for some astronomers in an eastern nation that watched the skies and looked at the things that God had made and wondered about them, what they meant. And it was also beginning for a corrupt ruler, an old king that was a puppet king under the domination of Rome. None of these people would ever be the same after the journey that they were taking. And because of the reason for their journey, neither would anybody else in the world be the same either. Not even you or me. So for the next few weeks, let's remember that the journey which these folks took is part of our trip as well, and it's the road that leads back home to the Lord. Now, many centuries before these happenings, when Israel was trying to rebuild itself, the Lord had sent Israel prophets, men who knew the Lord. They had heard His thoughts and words, and they spent their lives, some of them, telling the Israelites and the people surrounding areas there what God had said and what His directions were for them. And when their lives, when those people's lives there were dark, with bondage and battles and famine and pestilence and despair, these prophets would sometimes give them hope for their future and remind them that God still had a plan for their survival. Let me ask you something. Don't you long for that kind of reassurance? Life can get dark for us too. Even in this modern age of cell phones and miracle drugs and comfortable housing and all that, life can get dark as midnight if things go wrong for us, and they can go wrong a lot of ways. And the darkness of the spirit inside that can happen, that's even worse when you lose hope inside. And it's times like these that we need a light in our life. And sometimes we need food, and sometimes we need shelter, and those things are important. But sometimes we just simply need hope, a light to look toward, something to guide us and remind us that God is still there and He loves us. And that's what the old prophet Isaiah brought to God's people in dark times. He said these words in Isaiah chapter 9. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. And they that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. And then down in verse 6 it says, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Now, old Isaiah brought this good news to an oppressed people to give them hope. Do you have hope? What do you hope for? Do you hope for great things like world peace or an end to war? Or maybe your hopes are a little closer home. Maybe you're just hoping for a simple thing like a meal, a warm place to sleep for the night, or maybe a friend to say a kind word to you every now and then. We have need of these things and more. But the best thing is that God knows our needs. And the best thing is that He has even more in store for us than that, if we will just turn our lives over to Him. He wants us to live life more abundantly. He wants us to live it with Him when we leave here. And we will leave here. The time may be long or short, but we'll be leaving. And He sent His only begotten Son to us to die and rise again as payment for our sins, because we're all sinners. So that wandering journey that we're on, like these people were on in Isaiah's time and after, that started in the Garden of Eden, would eventually wind up back on the path to Him and to eternal life. That's what the Lord's after. And even when our lives get so dark that there's seemingly no way out, God gives us the promise of that light, the light of all men. That's what John called Him whenever he wrote about Jesus and His gospel, the light of Jesus Christ. He's the way back to the Father if we'll put our trust in Him. Faith in Him as God's only Son will get us there. So for the next few weeks, we're going to hear again about those that heard of Him for the first time, those that had written about Him hundreds of years before and believed in Him, and we're also going to hear about those that rejected Him and tried to do away with Him. And for the next few weeks, examine yourself. What do you hope for? Is your hope in Jesus? You know, Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. He said, nobody comes to the Father but through Him. Tie your hopes to Him. He's good for your journey, okay? Now, don't you miss next week. You come on back, and we're going to talk about this some more. Well, here's a song we're going to be doing in a little while over at the Old Arbor, but we're going to do it first right here. Troublesome times are here, feeling men's hearts with fear. Freedom we all hold dear now is at stake. Humbling your hearts to God, saved from the chastening rod. Seek the way pilgrims trod, Christians away. Jesus is coming soon, morning or night. Sound. All of the dead shall rise, righteous meet in the skies, going where no one dies, heavenward bound. Troubles will soon be o'er, happy forevermore, when we meet on that shore, free from all care, rising up in the sky, telling this world goodbye. Home we then shall fly, glory to share. Jesus is coming soon, morning or night or noon, many will meet their doom, trumpets will sound. Dead shall rise, righteous read in the skies, going where no one dies, heavenward bound, going where no one dies, heavenward bound. Folks, I want to see you next week if you can come on by. Come on over to the Arbor just in a little bit, and we'll sing that tune again, okay? God bless.